Le 2 août 2015,
On August 2, 2015, the international community, in other words, the UN, approved the Sustainable Development Goals. Is this only one more technocratic moment, or is it a real new starting point for all mankind towards its own progress and towards improved living conditions for the players? I am convinced it is a new start. Why? Well, we need to look back on history for a little while. During the Johannesburg summit in 2002, the UN players, which really means all the countries across the world, adopted the SDGs. That is technocracy at play again. It means the Global Development Goals. And everyone was delighted because for the first time, here was a real trajectory for about 15 years, so until 2015, on development. Yet for me, it looked like a small regression. Why? Because at the time of the Brundtland Committee, before the 1992 summit, before the Rio Conference, players at the time had finally succeeded in reuniting environment and development. And they chose a name which created a lot of buzz at the time, sustainable development. Unfortunately, at the time of the Johannesburg summit, unfortunately, these trajectories were divided again. On the one hand, the environment with the Convention on the Climate, the Convention on Biodiversity, the Convention on Desertification. On the other hand, the SDGs, development. So it ended up being a small theoretic regression, which in practice had many consequences, the biggest of which, the most famous one, was the Copenhagen summit, a failure. Why was it a failure? Because environment and development were pitched against each other. Why? Because developing countries, the poor ones, told those countries that wanted to stabilize CO2 emissions, hey guys, you're very kind, but you know, how on earth are we going to fuel our development? You polluted the earth by industrializing it, and now you're asking us to pay the bill, share the bill with you for the negative consequences of your own development, of your civilization, while we have not eradicated poverty in our own countries, etc. I believe that the international community got the message, and that during the summit, when the final decision was taken, i.e. in 2012, new objectives were set. And the origin of the term sustainable development was found, and that's how the Sustainable Development Goals came to be. It wasn't technocracy, first observation. Second observation, why did those that I call players, we talk about multiplayers, non-governmental players, states, why do the players all need to work together? First, let's sit back for a minute. That everyone is working together is a huge thing to say. For now, it means that 7.5 billion people, or rather 4 billion adults, are working together. Okay, it's true. Why? All these players represent not only the UN community, i.e. the states, because obviously the United Nations are made of the states, but also the surrounding communities, local authorities, non-governmental organizations, churches, trade unions, all kinds of citizens. And now, with the digital revolution, citizens are chatting on the internet about the destiny of the world, and also they chat on social networks. That was a true revolution. All the players were united to set the Sustainable Development Goals, to find a common goal in order to develop mankind in the best possible way. In other words, to provide what was called in the 18th century happiness, and secondly, what we now call development. Happiness and development. And this is essential because development should not be only quantitative, it should also be qualitative. So what exactly is the magic of Sustainable Development Goals? First of all, they are targets, real ones, which concern both development and the environment. There is a target on eradication of poverty, the first one, a bit like the parent target for the whole set of targets. There are targets, goals for the oceans, protecting our oceans. There are goals on preserving our climate so that it remains viable. There are objectives regarding justice and peace. There are goals to preserve biodiversity, which is under a serious threat today. In total, 16 goals and an additional one I will discuss later, SDG number 17, the inclusive SDG. The one by which the human community will really become a community. That's it. It's of capital importance. SDGs also include indicators, and that's essential. What does it mean? It means that sustainable development goals are the same for everybody, and that all of us, each country, each community, must be able to measure its progress. International statistics institutes, the ones reporting to the UN plus the national ones, measure the progress. Today, there are precisely 234 indicators which will help us move forward at the same pace. But let me dwell on this for a second, because moving forward at the same pace also carries a consequence, giving up on the environment here and giving up on development there. But why? Earlier in the 80s, and even more so immediately after decolonization, we used to measure the progress made by developing countries, considering that rich countries being rich, there was less need to measure their progress. Although economic progress was measured through the GDP, but we didn't need to measure human progress in developed countries. Education, or the famous happiness progress I mentioned earlier so much, and the same goes for well-being, well-living. Now, that's capital, because sustainable development goals all use the same metrics to measure progress in all the countries. So what it boils down to is that sustainable development progress creates equality. To wrap up, what do sustainable development goals create versus the other indicators I referred to, GDP, etc.? Well, quite simply, common good. What is common good or greater good? Common good consists in pooling resources that must remain viable so that close to 9 billion people can survive as well as the community, whereby people can manage resources, which, as we all know, are becoming scarce, and manage them together. The common good has been mentioned again and again for the last 30 years during international conferences. But until the SDGs emerged, it wasn't real. Whereas today, the phrase preserving the common good is a phrase embodied by the sustainable development goals themselves. One of the sustainable development goals indeed personifies common good and ties in with all the others in a way. It's the last one. 16 of the goals are somewhat specialized, and then there is SDG 17. SDG number 17 is the partnership goal. In Johannesburg and subsequently in Rio, during the 20th anniversary of the Rio conference also, we approved Partnership for Sustainable Development. SDG 17 is precisely the Partnership for Sustainable Development. It means that companies, and that's very important because the UN doesn't want to create a confusion between common good and public good, so we have private actions for private targets that may contribute to common good, exactly the same way that public agents make use of private players to maintain the common good. So there are companies, there are local authorities and communities, and their strength is increasing. Take, for example, a country such as the USA, withdrawing from the Paris Treaty or wanting to withdraw. There is still a little time before they really do it. Well, local authorities, which in the USA means all the American states, after all, it is a federation of states. Well, some of the local authorities say no, big towns are taking actions, and they all act as players. Not non-governmental organizations are other players, just as important because they are spurring sustainable development onwards. Churches are also playing an essential role, especially in South America, because they provide the long-term vision, not just a short-term one. And also trade unions, which rest on the social pillar of sustainable development, and they have shown themselves to be very active on social level of SDGs, etc. This is our contribution in Committee 21. We are a small workshop, one of the sustainable development players, and I myself have a tendency to say that sustainable development goals are a bit like the luminous phase of globalization. There is the dark side with all the disasters that will be caused by climate changes, the disasters that will be brought on by financialization or too much short-sighted vision, but there is also the luminous phase when all human players will set themselves a 15-year vision towards better living conditions for human populations that we constitute today. And that's why sustainable development goals are about more human development than just development.
C'est plus du développement humain que du développement tout court.